I've created a small, simple little scene for my animation to take place, I want to go in and start creating what's called an armature. These armatures are the basic skeletal structure of our character. At the end of the day, it's these armatures that are responsible for drawing or for moving our character. We're going to draw on top of these armatures to give our character some life and some individuality. But think of these armatures as the skeleton, as the bones. If we draw these armatures first, it actually makes the process of animating a little bit easier. We're not having to manage complex curves and complex character designs when defining and discovering the basic locomotion of our character. It also helps us establish the proportion and allows us to maintain those proportions across the entirety of the movement. We don't want our arms to magically get shorter or longer as we start to go through the design and the animation of our character. By starting off with these basic building blocks, we kind of set the foundation, if you will, a consistent foundation that can be repeated over and over and over again. We're going to go in and clean up these animations and combine these armature points at the end of the process. But in this first phase, in this first pass, let's create the armature so that we can block out the movements with some blocky shapes. And believe it or not, this is an excellent way to begin and a technique that animators across the world have been using for hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years. All complex shapes can get distilled into a whole series of simple shapes. So let's begin by drawing our simple shapes. As we did in the previous video, we started off by importing in this image as a background item inside of our Blender scene. Now we're going to draw on top of it. And I just want to just double check, make sure that I'm on my grease pencil item over here in my outliner. And I want to go in and create another animation layer. And we'll call this one character. Okay? And now we'll have all of the drawings for the character preserved on its own layer, which is a good practice. We separate the scene into all of its parts and pieces. Makes it easier to animate, easier to edit, and easier to manage. Let's go in and start creating our character. I'm just going to do this with a whole series of simple shapes. As you can see from the illustration here, we have a circle and a whole bunch of them. So maybe I create one circle and then I duplicate them. That'll go a whole lot faster. In addition, I also have a whole bunch of squares in here that I'm going to use for my legs and my arms. I'm going to create one, because when we create a square inside of Blender, it comes with a lot of dots. So by creating one, editing those dots, we can make it perfect and then duplicate it. And then lastly, I want to focus on the feet. And the feet have an important component in here that's worth pointing out. If you look carefully at certain parts of our animation, we need to bend the toe. We need to produce the illusion that there is the ball of the foot, and then there's the toe of the foot. And then way back over here, we have the heel of the foot. So we're going to create a shape that is roughly looking like this, okay? But we're also going to add a couple dots in here so that at certain points inside of the animation, we can get that bending movement. If we set the foundation for our drawings early on, and if we have a vision of what it is that we're going to need our animation to do, it's going to make it really easy to animate, to edit, and to manage all of these shapes inside of our timeline. Let's get to work. We have some things in here that we need to do, and let's jump in. As I mentioned before, I'm just going to very quickly draw some of these out, and I'm not going to go through the process of drawing all of them, but I am going to use not the line tool, the circle tool, to start defining these shapes. Now I can see already that I've created this circle with the wrong material, so I'm going to hit the escape tool and go up to my material selection menu. And I want the front, and I'm doing a spot check on the radius here, which is going to determine the thickness of our edges. And yeah, that's pretty close. I'm happy with that. It's not in the correct position, but that's okay, because I can always go into the edit mode with my stroke selection enabled, grab that slope, grab it, and of course scale it up as well. If you're having a hard time working with the scale tool, here's a great suggestion. Some folks have communicated to me that it's just way too sensitive, that a small movement makes the circle just get really big. Pay real close attention to where your cursor is before you activate the scale tool. If your cursor is really close to the object, then the scale tool is going to have a big result. If the cursor is pretty far away from the object, a small little movement or a big movement is going to have a small effect. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Notice that my cursor is right here. I got my circle selected. Hit the S key and small movement with my cursor is going to have a big change. However, if I move my cursor a little bit further out and then hit the S key again, a small movement is going to have a little change. Okay? We just get a little bit more control. There we go. A little bit more control when our cursor is a little bit further away from our object. Okay, so here's my circle. I'm pretty happy with that. For the body, bodies are basically gigantic cylinders for the most part. We'll talk about, later on in the course, we'll talk about how we can divide the body up into some pretty big zones that that lend itself to some natural deformation. But I think for today, I'm gonna duplicate my sphere and I'm gonna bring it down here at the bottom. Now I want this shape to be generally kind of uniform. Meaning that I want the curvature at the bottom to be the same as the curvature at the top. Well, here's a great little trick. I'm going to go into my point selection mode. I've been in the stroke selection mode for a long time, but if I go into my point selection mode, now I can go in and grab just a couple of the verts, and I'm going to see if I can try to grab just the top half, somewhere right around there. Yep, I'm pretty happy with that. There we go. I can grab them, move them up. And then voila, there's our shape. Yeah, I'm pretty pleased with that. That's a good little body shape. Now for the arms and the legs, there's a couple things that we need to consider as we build the armature of my animation here. Now I mentioned before that the legs, or the cube tool, the legs are nothing more than just cubes inside of Blender. However, when we draw a cube or a rectangle, we get a lot of points in here. So here it is, let's just hit the return key, I'm happy with that. If we jump into edit mode and then grab all the points, you can see that there's got a lot of points in here. Yeah, and we got some points in here that we don't necessarily want. So I'm gonna clean up these legs pretty quickly. I'm gonna grab these in here, hit the X key, we're gonna dissolve those, and all of these interior points I'm going to dissolve as well. And what this gives me is a cube just with four verts on each of the corners, which makes it very easy to edit and to control. There we go. So now I can just go in, stroke selection mode, grab it, rotate it around, and I can start positioning this where I want to define all the basic parts and pieces of my little animation, or of my character for my animation. The feet, however, are a little bit different. The feet, let me move these out of the way. The feet, again, they're going to be a cube. Let's go in and draw the feet. And we want to be able to have this natural bending in here for our feet. This is a really important moment for our walk cycles. It shows the flexibility of the foot and that it's physically being deformed and when it takes a step. So we need to make sure we have that in there. And luckily for us, we can very quickly create it just with the cube tool. Let's do it real fast. Here's a rectangle. Once again, we draw a rectangle looking pretty good. If we were going to edit mode, point selection, I'm gonna start deleting all of these guys in here, all the vertical ones on the left and right side of the cube, the X key, dissolve. But now the ones in the center, I wanna be a little bit more strategic with. I know I wanna have a pair of verts on the top and a pair of verts on the bottom. That way, I can start creating that hinge. These sets in here, I know it's hard to see, but like the number, if you're counting from the left to the right, so it would be the number, what, 1, 2, 3, it would be the number 4 set on the top and bottom. This is gonna be the ball of the foot itself, because this is the ball of the foot, we're right before our toes. So I'm gonna leave these here and then delete all these other ones. And this is gonna give me a good structure. So the toe shape is gonna be a rectangle with 6 control verts. This is the toe, and this is the heel and the ball of the foot itself. And now with that done, check it out, I just go and grab it, hit the grab tool. With grab tool, it's gonna allow us to move any points or any strokes around in the scene. If you wanna constrain it to be perfectly up and down, fire off the grab tool, and before you click with your mouse, hit the Z key, Z as in Z, and it's gonna constrain the location of those verts along the Z axis. Because now I have great confidence that I've maintained parallel lines here in the front and the back, and I'm pretty happy with that. Okay. Let's go ahead and get this in here. Something like that, there we go. Yeah, let's go in and I'm going to Just grab these guys once again. Grab them, move them up. Doesn't have to be exact. We're going to be doing a lot of editing on these guys, so it doesn't have to be super, super exact. Let's grab them, move them down again. Create our basic, very simple foot shape. I try to keep my lines as simple as I can, especially during this blockout stage. That way it's just real easy to see all of these shapes and how they're working inside of our movement. Yeah, there we go. So just four dots here in the front, two dots to represent the heel, and that's a great place to start. We're not trying to create a lot of detail. We're actually trying to keep it as simple as we can, which will allow us to really focus on how the poses are influencing our understanding of the movement, okay? When we start having complex drawings in there, it gets real difficult to see the locomotion, and it gets real difficult to see how and what we need to edit to, you know, kind of get things back on track a little bit. All right. So I'm pretty pleased with that. Excuse the dust. I just hit the wrong key on my keyboard. There we go. So now I have the basic building block for all the rest of the parts and pieces for my armature. If you look at it, we have a circle up here that we can easily duplicate to create the joints, like this. Can duplicate them very quickly. I like having circles for joints because they give it a nice visual representation of the rotation locations inside of the armature itself. Remember, these are kind of like skeletons, okay? These are kind of like skeletons, so I want to make them representative of the movement that they're going to do, something like that. We also have another great rectangle over here that we can use as a building block for the legs and the arms. Now, one of the things that I would suggest that you look at when you're doing your legs and your arms for this block out, and again, this isn't the final drawing. This is purely just a block out form. Let's do these up here at the top. There we go. I selected too many. Let's grab them and put them down. Maybe right in there. There we go. Is we want to keep these shapes pretty consistent. We want to keep the size pretty consistent. I've been working hard on establishing that top leg. Well, I'm going to duplicate it quite instantly, rotate it around, grab it, and now I have that bottom leg. Once you've defined the top, you now have a duplicate that you can use for the other leg as well. These two need to be the same, right? That way the proportions don't change. Same with this bottom leg, okay? This bottom leg here needs to be the same length. And let's just fix it real fast because it's too big. There we go. This bottom leg needs to be the exact same length as the bottom leg over here. That way the proportions don't change as we're animating, right? Because if the proportions are always changing, it's going to feel and look like your character is just kind of like this rubber hose, that it's growing and stretching just out of control, which is not the illusion that we want. So by having these duplicated parts, we ensure that they're always the proportions are always going to be consistent across the entire animation. We're not going to be drawing or redrawing all of these basic armature parts. We're going to be animating them. We're going to be rotating and moving them as we go through the poses. So by keeping everything consistent, it allows us to animate all of the proportions correctly and allows us to focus more on the poses and less on the drawings. So these animation armatures are a great way for you to quickly, and I mean very quickly, get up and running with the creation of your walk cycle.